everyone. My name is Weiqiong. I am assistant researcher in the Trusted Computing and Information Assurance Laboratory of Chinese Academy of Sciences. I'll introduce the Lattice-based fault attacks on the deterministic signature schemes of ECDSA and EDDSA on behalf of our group. This is a disclaimer, which is also represent our institution. And there are four points for my presentation. Now let's say the introduction. Before I introduce a deterministic signature, let's say the set chain attacks on ECDSA next signature schemes. Set chain attacks on various implementations of ECDSA have been continuously discovered during the last decades. The most classic attacks is below. If the NAS has a few bins leaked or repeated by power analysis or fault attack, some Lattice-based approaches can be employed to extract the private key. In which the most important approaches is Lattice attack. Lattice attack recovers the private key with some leaked information of a fault attack or power analysis. It's based as a Gaussian heuristic. Expected the shortest length of n dimensional, that is, L could be defined to be sigma L, which equals to this. Volume denotes the volume or determinant of L. If the exact shortest vector of random lattices is much shorter than sigma L, it shall be found in polynomial terms by using 3L and related algorithm. That is shortest vector problem. SVP for short. If L behaves like a random lattice and the distance between our lattice vector V and the target T satisfies this, we can see we can view V as the closest vector to T. This is a closest vector problem, CVP for short. By solving SVP or CVP, the private key can be recovered. To improve the security of ECDSA, deterministic signature schemes remove the randomness requirement from the algorithm. This is the algorithm for deterministic ECDSA of the signature generation. We can say the last key is It's derived by f. F is a function of d and e. If d is and e is picked, and if d and m is picked, k is picked. This is by ECDSA. We can also D1 and M is picked, K is picked. Now let's see the existing fault attacks on deterministic signature schemes. There are many two approaches. All belongs to differential fault attacks. The first one is solving linear equations. First, generate the correct signature RS with the same sinking D and input message M. Inject ports to produce a faulty signature R prime S prime during the calculation. Based on the signatures, solve two linear equations to recover the KD. For example, in EDDSA, S equals to the correct S equals to this, and the faulty S prime equals to this. By subtraction of these two linear equations, we can get the D zero directly. Also, we can get the value D, but with the subkey, D zero, we also can forge some signature which can pass the verification successfully. It has some limitations. The first one is only the scalar multiplication is the possible locations of fault injection. And it's easy to resist to be resisted by the convention of port well validation. The second approach is to analyze the deterministic signature is the technique of guessing and determining. First generate the correct one. Second inject ports on the intermediate values during the signature generation. To generate a faulty signature. For example, towards the intermediate value last key, and the key is changing to key prime. So we can construct a differential distinguish to get the 40 bits absent. Absolutely equals to this and we can derive the D zero. If D zero G, which is scalar multiplication, equals to P, we can get D zero. Now let's see our motivation. We found some problems about the second test above, that it's based on storage vaults. The first one, the invasions is obviously constrained by the enumeration complexity. Thus, the fault injection is required to be controlled and only affect limited bits of the target. Second, the targets considered in the existing attacks are concentrated, and it's still far away from covering all the possible attack paths. Besides, these problems will have some thought. Do there still exist any Lattice-based bot attacks on deterministic ECDSA or EDDSA for promising solution? So we have some ideas. Contrary to the traditional Lattice attacks on ECDSA, which makes the NAS partially same or leaked. Fault mode is to our fault mode is to make the fault touches partially random, not fixed, not same, not leaked. The fault touches include not only the NAS and the scale multiplication, but also more other intermediate values during signature generation. Now let's see all attacks. This is the attack overview. First, the intermediate values such as key, R, and the hash function generates them are disturbed randomly to generate some faulty signatures by fault attack. Second, based on the faulty and correct signatures with the common message, the private key can be recovered by serving the instances of SVP or CVP in Lattice. To sum up, there are two attacks. First, a fault attack. Second, a Lattice attack. Now let's see the first attack. This is the fault border. From this picture, we can see this is the intermediate value V, which have F bits. F bits, we can see there are W bits are disturbed randomly by fault injection. When V is changed to V prime will be involved in the following signature generation and will not be passed on the next invocation. V can be represented by this, which is our addition. And the epsilon is in this interval. LV is the maximum speed length of V, which is equals to F. To determine L, W is usually estimated to start from the highest or least significant bit of V. That is L equals to LV minus W or zero, or L equals to zero. The adversary can get the faulty signature. From the fault mode, we have this touches of fault injection, and the Lattice approaches. We can say deterministic ECDSA has more touches. This is the detailed touches. We can see H, F, K, the inverse of K, E, D, R. Every intermediate values as can be viewed as touched. This is for EDDSA H generate key, H generate R, hey, and the key R. Basically, the results of bot attack, we can do some key recovery. When gathering a correct signature and a minus one, fetching results for a common message, we can construct one of the following two relations. There are two equations. And the epsilon in this interval, a I b I w n are known value, d I, epsilon I h I are unknown value, but epsilon have interval. So we can construct a lattice L with a basis being the known vector of a matrix M as this. And the random model of what injection L behaves like a random lattice. Net target vector V set means this. V equals to X M. X equals to this. And the condition of this that is epsilon I have a limitation. If W is less than this, N is far greater than this. W is just slightly less than F. One of the following relation will hold. We can see when the fault value is represented by equation one, that is this. We have this. This is a SVP. When the fault value is replaced by equation two, which is this, then for vector u, we have this. That is the length of v and u is far less this. This is a CVP, which is similar with the lattice attack. Heuristically, the vector v in inequality one is the short. There's some footing in inequality this and v and u in this inequality. Now we can see we can view them as SVP and CVP respectively. And D which includes the information of lowercase d can be recovered by the approaches of lattice reduction. So with some instance of SVP or CVP. Now let's see some concrete instance of our attacks. This is takes the R during the calculation of S as target. When attack on deterministic ECDSA attacking, we can get the correct signature and the 14 and the n minus one 14 signature RASA for the same input message M, which can be represented as this. Let's EA equals to this, D equals to this, there must exist HA such that epsilon to equals to this, which is exactly in question one. If W as mentioned above, if W is less than this and the N is far greater than this. Actually, in experiment, N is usually equals to this formula. D can be recovered by solving SVP, and the D is in and the up the lowercase d equals to this. By the same way, we also can recover the sinking d zero by solving SVP. We also take the key before of the calculation of key g as target to attack on deterministic ECDSA. Similarly, with the correct signature and n minus 1, 40 signature, we have these equations. Let AI equals to this, BI equals to this, and D equals to this. Just said D is capital D is lowercase d. There must exist HA meet this, which is exact in exactly equation two. As mentioned above, if W is slightly less than F, F is the keyness, and N is far greater than this, the private key can be obtained by solving CVP. By the same way, we also can attack on ECDSA. We also can implement in D0 can be found by solving CVP. Now let's see the attack on hash function generating the intermediate values. Here take the last key as example. After the L-rand compression, the modular addition of the register AL to HL and A0 to H0 are calculated, and the results are assigned to register AL to HL as a hash value. This is for this deterministic ECDSA. This is for EDDSA. Once a fault is injected into this register, the calculation of the addition of the hash value during the foreign reduction key will be affected by the fault. Based on this fault model, we have the following targets during the calculation of last key. We can see the register, the modular additions, and the hash value during the reduction of key are the targets. Now let's see the experiment and the complexity discussion. First, this is the experiment condition. The experiments are conducted in a common computer, and the BKC algorithm is important, which have which has block size of 20, implemented in NTL library. And a pursued random generator is used to generate the input message M and N minus one groups of W bits random number beta I. And the choose target way is set to be V X or beta I, which is equivalent to V plus epsilon A mod N. If the thinking can be recovered finally, the experiment is marked successful, otherwise failed. So, based on the condition, we have the following results. We can see the maximum W in our experiment is up to 250, which is slightly less than the total bind in theory. Theoretical result is 253. N is approximate to this in experiment, which is far less than the theoretical result. When W equals to 128, one correct and 240 signatures suffice to recover the key with high success rate. This is for ECDSA, and F is equal to 250 and 5 and 50 and 3. The result is same with the ones of this deterministic ECDSA. We also make some comparisons with the existing attacks. Many DFA denatural fault attacks. We can see the turnover band of 40 bits is far greater than the previous DFA. When W is equal to 128, our attack still is feasible. Now, next, we'll see the conventions. First, we will see the existing conventions. The first one, introducing randoms to the derivation of nonce key. This is the exact idea of hundred signature schemes. This strategy can be theoretically defeated or attacked, but it remains unclear whether it can be used to resist all quote attacks. Data integrity protection, parity check, such as parity check, CRC, and the point validation. Parity check and the CRC will leave some rooms for further injection. So checking whether the input and output points are on the original in elliptic curve cannot resist our attacks. Signature verification before outputting. So attacks select key before the calculation of KG and the hash functions generated key can survive. But the other proposed attacks can be prevented. Consistency check of repeated computations. This can be effective to resist all the proposed attacks, but this confirmation may not be infectious, which is affordable for some devices such as IoT devices. So we propose all countermeasures. This is for EDDSA. So Factor 8 blind compression in the hash function H generated key are calculated prior to obtain two identical nonces, key 1 and key 2. The final 8 round compressions in the hash function H generated are also calculated prior to obtain R1 and R2, which is also same. Which are also same. A random infect factor beta is introduced, which has the same bit length with key. And is generated per signature. Finally, S is calculated by this. If key 1, key 2, R1, R2, D0 have some 14 bits. S is 14. This is for deterministic ECDSA. Similarly, the final 8 round compression in F generated key are calculated trap to obtain to identical as key 1 and key 2. Calculate the final 8 round compression to generate E1 and E2, R1 and R2 by the same way. The prior key D is invoked trap during the calculation of S, and it's defined as D1 and D2. Finally, S is calculated by this. If any intermediate value is 14, S is 14. Now let's give a summary. By notice the algebraic structures of the deterministic algorithms, we show Lattice-based fault attacks can also be applied to deterministic ECDSA and EDDSA schemes. The proposed method allows small chains of target for fault object. There are 12 and 8 fault targets for deterministic ECDSA and EDDSA respectively, even including the hash functions and the private key in itself. The proposed method can turn the net more 40 bits. The proposed Lattice method is not to eliminate all the 14 patterns, but rather to solve the instances of Lattice problems. This makes the turnover 14 bits can be close to the size of the same key. Experiments demonstrate that for 50 and 6-bit deterministic ECDSA and EDDSA, the thinking can be recovered effectively with high probability, even if the intermediates are infected by this respectively. The proposed infective conventions are efficiently to resist all attacks. My presentation is over. Thanks for your attention. If you have any question, please send it to my emails.